So here's a question for you. How are you holding up in this heat? Summertime isn't always fun for everyone. For some folks, it's depressing. Summer blues and summer depression are a real thing. Dr. Josh joins us to explain. And Dr. Josh, are we talking about something that can be really go to a doctor for?
Oh, absolutely. It's called, it's seasonal affective disorder, which a lot of people know about as winter depression. But the technical term is actually reverse seasonal affective disorder. And so about a tenth of the people who get seasonal affective disorder get it in the summer, not in the winter. It's triggered in the summer, and it's a very real depression.
How many people were we talking about?
About a tenth of 14 million or so.
Wow.
But it definitely needs to be seen by a mental health professional. But a larger number of us get the summer blues, kind of like the winter blues. We feel lethargic, we feel cranky. We're not interested in doing anything. The summer blues, though, you can manage on your own.
Okay, so what triggers this? What causes this, and what can we do about it?
We're not exactly sure what causes it exactly, but we tend to think about it as prolonged exposure to daylight can sometimes interfere with our mood cycle.
Oh.
Dehydration, problems with our sleep, the quality of our sleep. We may be sleeping the same amount, but when we're hot, we don't sleep as well.
Mm.
And much like in the wintertime, we tend to overdo our schedules in the summer. So there's things that we can do to manage that to make us feel better.
Okay, so what's first on the list?
Obviously trying to stay cool as much as you possibly can, but particularly actually at night so that you sleep well.
Mm.
You may be sleeping the same amount, but we want you to sleep cooler because you'll sleep better. Related to that is hydration. Everyone knows about not getting dehydrated, but you need to drink throughout the day because when we're dehydrated, we feel fatigued, we feel lethargic. The other thing is we may want to back off our exposure to daylight just a little bit, so maybe 2 hours instead of 4 hours. The last one is exercise. Now, you got to be careful about exercising outside, but don't give up the exercise because it'll boost your mood.
Mm-hmm.
It'll also boost your metabolism. All those things together should lift your summer blues. If they don't, you definitely need to talk to a mental health professional.
We know that exercise releases those great endorphins.
Exactly.
So that's really key, but when do you have to go to the doctor?
If you've tried those things and it's not working and you're still feeling down or sad or blue, or if you feel at all suicidal, you talk to a mental health professional.
Wow.
Or you talk to your primary care physician. Also, if you want more information about this, JP Dice and I have actually done a podcast on this, Behind the Front podcast, and you can get that on the WBRC podcast network.
Dr. Josh, as always, thank you for being with us, and we're learning more and more about this.
Thanks,
you.
Sarah.
All right, Sheldon.